Dealer takes one.
Fascinating. Mm-hmm. Fraught with possibilities.
Dealer bets 50.
Well, never let it be said that Garrison Collier walked away from a bet, be it whales or sealing wax, so I'll see your 50, sir. And I'll raise you 50.
See your 50. And raise you 100 more.
Glory, my dear. Glory.
Yes. Yes, Grandfather.
Glory. Would you be good enough to fetch my money case from the hotel?
Well, of course, I'd be delighted to.
She's the very light of my life, that sweet girl.
I raise you 100. How about it, Kalia?
Well, of course, of course. You can count me in. Glory will be back with the money shortly, and in the meantime, I see no reason why we should delay, so with your permission, sir, I'll play light.
All right. Until she gets back.
Scott due back from Stockton today?
Yeah, it's supposed to be. Unless they figured out a reason to stay longer.
Like wine, women, and song, maybe?
Yeah, wine, women, and song. Pete, that's three good reasons.
Yeah, the stage should be long any minute now.
Just to keep things sociable, I am afraid I shall have to insist on another raise. 100.
Call.
Three lovely ladies. Full.
You lose. Four brothers.
My congratulations, sir. That is a very good hand.
I count 500 you owe me.
Yes, yes, of course.
Grandfather? Oh, Grandfather, we've been robbed.
What? What are you saying, girl?
Oh, it's gone. The money case isn't under the mattress anymore. It's gone.
Oh, there, Glory. It's perfectly all right. It doesn't matter.
Oh, Grandfather, what are we going to do now? We don't have any money.
Nonsense. We've plenty of money back in St. Louis. We'll merely contact the bank. But first, we must find the sheriff and tell him what has happened.
We have no sheriff in this town.
What? You have no representative of law and order?
We make our own law and order. You owe me $500.
Well, sir, but under the circumstances...
$500.
But surely you can't expect my grandfather to pay you right now.
That's exactly what I expect.
Oh, never mind, Glory. The gentleman is quite right. I'll write a draft on the bank. If you'll give me your full and complete name, sir...
Wade Hatcher.
Wade Hatcher. H.
No bank drafts. Cash.
But don't you understand? We've been robbed.
The only thing I understand is hard money.
But, Mr. Hatcher, if you won't accept a draft on the bank, you'll have to wait until I could wire St. Louis.
All right. You've got 2 days to come up with $500.
Mr. Hatcher, please be a little more practical, even if the bank would send the money at once. It would take at least a week to get here.
Then you better find another poker game. And this time you better win. Or this town is going to get a $500 funeral.
Hey, come in.
Well, we in business or not, Scott?
Ask the horse trader in the family.
Hello, Pete.
Hello, Mr. Lancer.
Made $900, Johnny.
$900?
Yeah.
Are those old dust kickers?
I told you this man was a horse trader.
Come on, I'll buy the first round.
Oh, no, thank you, Johnny. I think all I want to do is find a nice hot tub and disappear out of sight for a while.
That makes two of us. That old bucket shook everything loose but our teeth.
Yes, I got the horses over at the livery stable.
Wait a minute. Let's not forget what we went for. Hey, Pete. I'll take the one with the stock and bank printed on. All right. Stock and bank. There it is. Good trip, Mr. Lancer?
Profitable, Pete. Profitable.
Sure looks like it. And if you'll sign here.
Right here. A third of this is yours. You carry it. It's heavy.
My pleasure, my pleasure.
$900 returned from company security.
Right there. There you are, Pete.
It's an old family heirloom. My dear departed grandmother got it from a Dutch sailor right off the ship in New York.
Really?
Yes. You see, my grandfather's 87 now, and he's just suffered a stroke. I'm all alone. I have to find the means to take care of him now. All I ask is just a fair price. Just enough to take care of my grandfather in his last remaining days.
Lady, I'm not in the jewelry business, but I might be able to find someone that I could sell it to.
Oh, could you?
I'll tell you what. I'll give you $2 cash money or $3 trade.
This town ain't fit for decent people. Steves, high riders. And no law to run them out of town.
Those two men out there, the ones who lost their money, who are they?
Them's the Lancers. They own a ranch just south of town. And one of the few families around here who always pay their bills.
Well, now, those are my kind of folks.
Mm-hmm.
that's hopeless. How can you expect to win $500? You can't even deal seconds.
Oh, glory, glory. Where's that old spirit? We've been up against it before.
Here. Well, we always had running room before.
They're still there?
Like buzzards sitting on a fence.
Well, we're not going to let them see they've got us scared. We're going to bluff it out to the end.
How much money do we have left, Grandpa?
Maybe $30. Barely enough to start me in one good poker game.
Well, you can make that last till I get back.
Back? Back from where?
Those men down there are watching you, not me. I can go to Stockton and get a bank loan.
But you need collateral for that, my dear, and we don't have any.
Why, Grandfather, I do believe I have a certain charm. Or so you've said many times.
You're a treasure, Glory. A rare treasure indeed.
Goodness.
Picked a good place to have trouble, lady.
Way out here?
Yeah, hill there. The ranch house on the other side.
Well, there he is.
Name's Johnny Lancer.
I'm pleased to meet you, Johnny. I'm Glory. Glory Smith.
Don't you worry about your buggy. We'll fix it back at the ranch house. Climb on.
That's very kind of you. What did you say the name of your ranch was?
I didn't. But it's Lancer.
Oh, Lancer. I don't think I've ever heard of it. After I arrived in town, they told me there wouldn't be another stage to San Jose for a week. So I rented a buggy.
That's mighty dangerous country for a young woman traveling alone, Mrs. Smith.
Yeah, I guess it is, but I'm anxious to settle my grandfather's estate and get back to St. Louis.
No, I have a feeling that once you get there, you'll want to stay. It's a pretty good cattle country.
No, it'll be a sad visit for me with Grandfather gone.
Well, I'd love to visit St. Louis sometime.
Would you? Well, if you do, I hope you'll come and stay with me at my house. Oh, it's so lovely. It's very tall and stately. It has white marble columns and a rose garden. Oh, it's set way up on a hill in a grove of black-heart hickory. And if you look off into the distance, you can see the Mississippi River gently rolling down towards New Orleans. Oh, I tell you, it's just... Well, Teresa, why don't you get me started? I don't want to stop.
Tell me, Miss Smith, do you happen to know the Emmett Russell family in St. Louis?
No, I don't think I've heard of them.
Oh, Scott, you know, St. Louis is a pretty big city.
I know, I've spent considerable time there.
Well, perhaps you have some other friends you could name.
Well, I doubt if you'd know them if you've never heard of Emmett Russell. He happens to be the mayor of St. Louis.
Well, I'm afraid you've caught me. Women just aren't any good when it comes to politics, are they?
Well, Gloria's right. I mean, I don't even know the name of the mayor of Morrocoyo.
Teresa, there is no mayor in Morrocoyo.
Well, see?
I hope you'll give me another chance to redeem myself.
Discussing mutual friends in St. Louis?
Discussing whatever you like.
Miss Smith, tell us some more about this ranch that you're trying to sell.
Oh, well, I don't really know too much about it. I guess it's about 2,000 acres.
2,000? I suppose you're looking for a total cash offer.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Well, you're not?
Well, I was thinking more of a down payment of sorts. Something to show good faith. $500 or so.
I'd say $500 is a pretty good show of faith.
Well, good land is hard to find anymore in California. A man has to consider all possibilities.
Even if the opportunity is 100 miles from here?
Scott, if you climb a tall enough tree, you can look over and see what's behind the next hill.
I thought this was supposed to be a social occasion, not a business meeting.
Teresa, you're right. Miss Smith, may I offer this suggestion? You stay here at Lancer for the next several days as our guest.
Oh, no, I don't think... I couldn't.
Now, I have some friends that might be interested in your ranch.
Really?
Well, at least let us give you the benefit of me asking them.
Well...
it might save you a long trip to San Jose.
For a few days, then.
Oh, that's wonderful. It'll be nice to have another woman around here. Oh, come on. Why don't we go upstairs and find some clothes a little more comfortable for you to wear? You know, without the lace.
Would you excuse me, gentlemen?
Sure. Juanita, la cena estaba muy bueno.
Muchas gracias, patrón.
De nada. I'm going to finish my brandy out on the porch. I'd appreciate some company. Scott, what's the problem?
About what?
Miss Smith.
She's a very beautiful woman.
I didn't think you noticed.
I noticed.
Well?
I don't know. There's just something about her. The ready answers, that smile she bores into you. She's pretty smooth.
That's what I like about her. Smooth, smiling, always ready with the answers.
Just a minute before you start locking horns over Miss Smith's hand. There's a little business proposition I'd like to discuss.
About land investment?
Scott, when I bought this ranch 25 years ago, it was nothing but dead scrub and cactus. The worst possible investment I ever could have made. Yet I went into it with my eyes open, wishing I had better sense. Now, this didn't turn out too bad, did it?
Man's got a point.
I guess he does.
Well, now that you concede that, I've got another point I'd like to bring up, and that is that we've got a nice, tidy $900 profit tucked away in our sock. Now, the bright thing to do would be to reinvest it.
Buying land we've never seen?
No, that wouldn't be smart. Johnny, I want you to ride into town and wire Cleve Harper in San Jose.
Just to find out about that land?
That's right. And when we hear from him, we'll know whether or not we should invest.
Good. And it's all worked out.
For you?
Well, not quite. There's a little cooperation I'd like from you, Scott. After all, you know, we have a guest. Try to be a little pleasant. After all, the tradition goes back a long time.
Tradition?
Yes. The affinity of Lancer men for beautiful young women. Huh?
Say, You get that answer back from San Jose in the next couple hours, I'll be over to Slim.
Very well, Mr. Lancer.
Why, there's not a man amongst you who isn't sitting here right this moment praying he'll find his own El Dorado. Straight five-card draw induces wild. Oh, it's there, hidden like foxfire in a bayou swamp. If you want to hit it big, you've got to gamble big. Open on anything, no limit on raises. You've got to put your soul straight on the line. Devil take his due. Now, let's find out amongst you who has the spirit of adventure.
I'll open for 50 cents.
You sure you want to risk everything, Fred?
I think so.
I fold. Looks like you gentlemen have found yourselves a helpless victim. Ah, you, sir. Would you care to join us? It's a friendly game, good conversation, and charitable companions.
What's the limit?
Well, 50 cents. Of course, if you insist, we might be persuaded to increase it.
It's just fine with me.
The heart of a liar.
I was looking for Teresa.
Did you expect to find her in the barn, Miss Smith?
It's certainly hot today, isn't it?
I hadn't noticed.
I shouldn't think a back east gentleman like you would enjoy field hand labor.
Nobody said I enjoyed it.
Well, it'd be nice to be rich and find a shady tree somewhere and sit down and watch the world go by. You think you'll ever be rich?
Anybody in the ranching business doesn't have time to sit under a tree, rich or otherwise.
It's too bad. Still, it might be nice, huh? I don't suppose you and I'll have much of a chance to get to know each other, well, with me just passing through and all.
Probably not.
You know, a woman doesn't get a chance to meet many nice people. Not these days. Not like your father and brother.
I'll relay the compliment.
Well, I guess you'd like me to quit bothering you, huh?
Well, I do have my work to finish, Miss Smith.
Oh, well, go right ahead. I'll just sneak out quiet as a little church mouse.
Fell on you.
Oh, maybe it was worth it. I like Glory a lot better than Miss Smith.
Oh. Perhaps it might be safer if you spent the rest of your visit near the house.
Oh? Safer for who, Mr. Lancer?
I have three nines.
Well, I win the pot, you win the deal.
Far be it from me to break up a lucky game. If For the local residents, that is. I wouldn't be in California at all if a very dear friend of mine hadn't recently passed away.
That's too bad.
As a matter of fact, he was a rancher like yourself.
Well, that ranching, you know, it's a tough life.
Yeah, but a profitable one, I imagine, for those with adventurous spirit. And Jack saw better. He was a widower, too, poor man. 3,000 acres of prime cattle land, and no one to leave it to but me, his oldest, truest friend.
Better than a kick in the mouth, ain't it?
Well, a man of city ways. What could I do with 3,000 acres of prime meadow and river?
Pass.
I'm home for two bits. You might try working it, raising a herd of your own.
Cards, gentlemen.
Two. Three.
Well, I'm growing old and tired. All I want to do is to return to St. Louis, to the comforts of my home in my declining years. Oh, the dealer takes three. No, I shall just have to sell those 3,000 acres for anything I can get. At a considerable loss, no doubt.
What'd you say your friend's ranch was?
San Jose.
San Jose?
Mm-hmm. With money as scarce as it is today, I shall probably have difficulty in finding a cash buyer.
You win her out. I'll bet 50 cents. You know, Mr. Collier, you could find someone to give you a down payment. I mean, just to show good faith, you know?
Say, that's a good idea.
Yeah, I thought maybe you'd like that. You say you live in St. Louis? What's it like to live in a big city like that?
Well, we live modestly, but comfortably. I'll see you, sir. My home is high on a hill, surrounded by a grove of black-heart hickory. It's white, with marble columns and a rose garden.
I bet you sit on top of that hill and watch the Mississippi gently rolling off to New Orleans?
Why, yes. How did you know that?
Well, just a lucky guess. Tell me more about this ranch.
Are you interested?
Oh, yes, Mr. Collier. I'm interested.
All right, hitch him up.
I missed you at lunch today.
My apologies, Miss Smith.
Doesn't matter. I know you had a great deal of work to do. I've decided I'm not going to stay any longer.
Because I didn't join you for lunch?
No, of course not. It's just that I'm not accomplishing anything here. At least not when it comes to making friends.
Well, let's just say I'm hard to get to know.
After the accident in the barn, I was thinking. You may not like the idea, but you did save my life. I want you to know that I'm grateful.
It was my fault. The rope slipped.
Well, anyway, I want you to have this. It's a family heirloom. My grandmother got it from a Dutch sailor in New York. Of course, I don't know very much about gems, but I've been told they're very good ones.
Thank you, but...
You may please. I do want you to have it. It's the only way I have of expressing how I feel. Well, I guess I'll be gone by the time you finish work, so we'll just make this goodbye.
Goodbye. Murdoch doesn't have a friend who's interested in your grandfather's ranch. It's him. He's the one.
And what about you?
Well, I want you to stay.
Well, then I'll stay for a while.
Double check on story. No such ranch in vicinity of San Jose, Cleve Harbor.
I would have come back sooner, but I wanted to wait for that and make sure.
A swindle, a pure bald-faced swindle, and I almost swallowed it whole.
Well, I took a pretty good bite myself.
Are you sure it was Glory's grandfather you were playing cards with?
I'm positive. That old fox is as smooth as greased glass. You know, I bet he could sell a dead horse to an Indian.
Johnny, get the lady's buggy out of the barn. I'll have her waiting downstairs.
No. This is something I want to attend to myself.
What else could I do? I was stranded in a small town. I had no money, no friends. All I want is to get my grandfather to the doctor in San Francisco. It's his heart. He doesn't even know it. There's not much time left. What would you do if he were your only living kin? Wouldn't you try anything to save him?
Turn it off, Glory. It doesn't work anymore.
All right. How about the plain, dull truth? My grandfather isn't sick. He's just a bad card player. We need $500 to pay off a gambling debt. And if we don't pay it, the man is going to kill him.
Sorry.
Sure. I'll bet you are.
Well, it's a long ride back to town in the dark. I guess you can wait until morning.
Do I have to?
Well, that's up to you, Miss Smith.
Scott. Just one thing. That house I told you about in St. Louis.
The white one. Marbled columns in the rose garden.
Yeah. Well, that's the only part of the story that I didn't make up. There's a house like that. I used to see it when I was a little girl. When my grandfather came over from England, he used to take me down the river on a paddle boat. And there it was on a hill, in a grove of black heart hickory. I used to pretend that that house was mine. I guess because I didn't have one of my own. It's funny. After 100 trips or so, it gets awfully hard to tell the difference between the truth and a lie. Well, keep your hands in your pocket, cowboy, or somebody might pick them clean.
Good night, Miss Smith.
Won't start another poker game, friend, but it will allow me to buy you another drink. Your health, sir.
Explain,
I was just going
to... You try to leave town before your debt's paid off. I'll kill you where you stand. One more day, Collier.
Well, unless I've left out a decimal point, we have enough money to buy that purebred bull we saw in Stockton and still stay within the monthly budget.
Sounds good to me.
Hmm? Teresa, you're a member of the family.
Oh, it's fine with me. I'll wait another month for sewing machine.
What about you, Scott?
Oh, yeah, sure, anything you say.
And what did I say?
I wasn't listening, I'm sorry.
Well, Scott, we might as well get this out in the open and be done with it. If you have any feelings for this young woman...
If I have any feelings for this woman, it's my business. My problem. Mine and nobody else's.
Hey, come on now. We don't have to start chewing on each other. I mean, I brought her here, didn't I? It's just much my fault.
Why should it be anyone's fault? I mean, we believed in her because we wanted to believe in her.
Why does a girl like Gloria have to lie anyway? A man would be glad to hand her the world and thankful for the privilege.
Including you?
What does it matter? She'll be gone in the morning.
Scott. If the Lancer Ranch is going to get that purebred, somebody's got to go buy it. There's an early stage to Stockton. There's $600 there, $500 for the purebred, and $100 in case you stumble into a good bottle of whiskey on the way back.
barn.
Yeah, it sounds like it.
Where's Glory?
She's in her room.
No, she's not. The money's gone.
Our guest forgot to say goodbye. Let's show her some manners.
Granddaughter. She is up to something. Go get Hatcher.
Hurry, Grandpa.
But, dear, since you were able to get alone, I see no reason why we should sneak out of here in the middle of the night like common criminals. Tomorrow morning, we'll pay Hatcher this blood money and...
Oh, Grandpa, I don't have time to argue with you. Just do as I say, please.
Very well. I don't suppose I have the right to decide the matter, do I?
Grandpa, why, our luck's gonna change, you'll see. In the next town, everything's gonna be all different.
Yes, that's all we need, Glory. Another town. Another deal of the cards. I'll take the money.
No, I'll take that, Grandpa. You take the valise.
Oh, yes, of course. I expect Hatcher will be waiting for us downstairs, won't he?
Well, if he is, we'll give him the money and keep right on going. That's important. Do you understand it?
Yes.
We give him the money, but we don't stop and talk.
Oh, there's precious little to talk about with a common scoundrel like that.
You're right, Scott. There's her buggy over there.
Smith? What is this, Glory? Who are these men?
They're just some friends of mine, Grandpa.
How's your poker game?
Why, yes, of course. The rancher. Well, if there's been any misunderstanding, gentlemen, I'm sure we can...
Miss Smith, we'd like to have the $600 you borrowed.
It all seems so easy.
Why, Glory?
Oh, it's a long story, and I don't think you're interested.
How about me, lady? $600 makes killing easy.
Better give him what he wants, Miss Smith.
I want the money sack. $500 for the old man's debts, $100 for the trouble to collect it. Hand it over.
No, I don't think so.
You better do what he says, Glory. The money's not that important.
Oh, really? It was a moment ago.
Please, Glory, give him the money.
No.
Don't shoot!
get them on their horses and get them out of here.
Remember the riverboats, Glory, back in St. Louis? That's where we should have stayed, in the protective arms of a gentle society.
Yes,
Grandpa. Come on.
Thanks for the shop.
My pleasure.
Hey, Scott. Want to see what you put in the sack?
Is this what you took all those chances for? A handful of washers?
Washers? Well, there must be some mistake.
Your $600 is back at the ranch. It's in a bucket beside the barn door.
Why?
Let's just say I'm hard to get to know. Oh, don't you believe me, Mr. Lancer?
Can you give me a good reason why I should?
How about you, Scott? Are you a gambling man?
One day I'd like to see that house on the hill myself.
Well, it only takes a boat ride down the Mississippi. Keep your eyes open, cowboy. You can't miss it.
Well, I think we're finished here.
I mean finished. Let's have the money.
The lady said she left the money in a bucket by the barn door.
Believe her?
Believer.
Well, for some fool reason, I guess I do too.
The deal of the cards. That's all we need, Glory. A fresh start.
Sure, Grandpa. Just another deal of the cards.